About 65 million years ago, a comet hit the Earth, which created a chain of events that caused the dinosaurs and other species to go extinct. Current theories place the impact of the comet near Chicxulub, Mexico, where the remnants of a comet impact have been discovered using ground-penetrating radar. However, comets rarely remain whole. They tend to break up in space, and the impact is usually more than one piece of the comet hitting the ground in more than one location. Considering the size of the Chicxulub comet, we should at least entertain the possibility that the Chicxulub impact zone is just a minor site of the overall comet impact. Let us consider the possibility that the Chicxulub crater is just a fragment of the main body. Let us also consider the main body to be about 30 miles in diameter before it hit, and that it impacted more to the middle of the Gulf of Mexico. Further, let us realize that because of the size of the Earth compared to the comets, it would be extremely rare for a comet to come straight down from space to hit the Earth. The chances of hitting the Earth at an oblique angle are far greater than for a comet to fall straight down from the sky, simply because there is far more surface area exposed for an oblique hit around the circumference of the Earth's profile. To hit the bullseye in the middle of the Earth's profile would be a least likely scenario for a randomly approaching comet. After impacting the Earth at an oblique angle, the comet nucleus would penetrate underground more or less sideways, and as the surface evidence shows, it would have traveled about 1,000 miles under the Earth's surface before resting in southern Illinois, somewhere under Jefferson and Marion counties. The impact would throw up a curtain of water and dirt and spread the resulting mud across Texas and Louisiana. The resulting mud would flow back into the Gulf, which would be followed by millions of years of erosion. As the comet penetrated the Earth, it would puncture a tunnel and create a wake in the Earth's surface. The comet would compact the surrounding material as it bored through the Earth, which later would collapse into the void the comet had created. A 30-mile-wide comet nucleus of solid iron would create a lot of damage underground. It would also crack the North American continent and create the conditions for the Mississippi River to form. Even though the comet nucleus finally came to rest underground, the Earth's surface would show signs of raised land. Notice the ravine structures in the lifted land area. These ravine structures are unique to this particular location. This lifted land topography is consistent with the hypothesis that the core of the comet rests underground, perhaps 100 miles or more below the surface. The surface scarring of the Earth today, which shows evidence of a large object having penetrated the ground below. This lifted land topography is consistent with the hypothesis that the core of the comet rests underground, perhaps 100 miles or more below the surface. The surface scarring of the Earth today still shows evidence of a large object having penetrated the ground below. During the New Madrid earthquakes in 1811 and 1812, there were numerous reports of water and sand plumes shooting out of the ground, and entire regions of ground just suddenly sinking. There is no tectonic fault system under the Mississippi River, at least not those types of faults caused by the continents slipping past each other. A geological analysis of the Mississippi River Valley shows compression stresses all along what could be the path of the solid iron comet nucleus that struck the Earth 65 million years ago.